Rose Christine Machado. She was born on my mom's birthday, which gives her her middle name. Christine. It's my mom's name. So, she's rocking. She loved me forever. She's a cruiser. A little troublemaker.
Moon the camera.
Started surfing when she was 8 months. It's all good, you know? Brought her over here. This was her first trip. She's never actually been on a plane. Take her to the beach, and she plays in the water, and she loves it, so. Morgan Stanley. You know, he started surfing pretty late. Like, he must have been 20, in his 20s. I think we just both love what we're doing so much that we can just have a good time. And I just see, like, how passionate he is about surfing. Always wants to learn, you know. He's, like, asking me, you know, why. How does he do this and how does he do that and how's he gonna get better at this? And he's just psyched to be out in the water.
It's all worked out for the best, you know. Surfing has really, it's really helped my life out in the sense that it's made me really stoked on something, and it's a way that I met my wife. You know, it's also a thing that my family does, my kids do, and they love it. And it's just, it just ties so many things together. I mean, it's helped my business out tremendously, and it's, you know, it's just such a powerful force, and I can understand why people just can be so stoked on it.
It's good, you know, those are the best people to surf with, you know, that are amped, that want to get better, that want to surf, and, you know, that are passionate. They'll teach you just as much as anyone.
I know you can. We'll be right back.
You know, I've been surfing there for so long, so. But there's all these new waves, you know, that you go and when you're around us, if you're in the vicinity of a spot that you've always wanted to get good and you miss it, then that's just gut-wrenching.
A lot of people don't realize how much surf there actually is here, and it's actually kind of a secret once you've been to this country and you've experienced a couple of the coastlines and served a couple of the best spots, then I think you know it's become the favorite, and I don't think a lot of people will understand it if I had to explain it, but it's got really consistent, really amazing surf, and that's what I think of when I think of Africa. Yeah, and you don't understand, the last 3 weeks has been bullshit, absolutely bullshit. Some a new spot every day that's just going off its head, so we've been completely surfed out over the last 3 weeks.
Moving on, moving in, tell me where do we begin? How about at the end when an old stub friends to the end? This leaving has nothing to do with you, everything to do with me. I need to be.
Feeling really bad, and then that was the worst thing in the world. I was so sick, I didn't want to even get in the water for that contest, and my brother Peter ended up going up the coast and scoring. the culture on the coast a lot different to the culture inland. When I went to Paris, then I was blown away by how like historical everything was and old and just so beautiful. And I've never really, that was the first time I've ever been to Paris, and I've been to France 3 years in a row, and I had a completely different impression of it just from living on the coast for those 3 years compared to actually being in the city. We traveled a bit. We went up north, and I think Travis was going off in these little bowls that we found.
Sort of inherently Hawaiian. When I say that, I mean that it started here, and when we grew up here, you jump in the water and you kind of ride whatever it is that you have available to you, whether it be a bodyboard, you know, a skimboard, you body surf, longboard, shortboard. So to me, it's all encompassing. And so we came up with the concept for Nalukai Quarterly, which is an all-inclusive sort of encompassing concept. Nalukai means ocean wave. And just to give sort of a perspective from our way out.
Travel a bunch and getting to see different places and eat different foods that I probably wouldn't get to see or eat if I didn't start surfing. So I'm pretty stoked. Just to be able to go see it and touch it with my own hands was just pretty incredible for me. I was pretty stoked to be able to get all the way over there, like halfway around the whole world, and be able to
do that just from surfing. Being away from home's hard if you're gone for like 8 months or 9 months out of the whole year, because Maui, so it's warm like 365 days a year. And there's always waves there, but it's just something that it's just been a dream to do ever since I was real young, to be able to do what I'm doing now. So I wouldn't take it back for anything, and I don't bitch or moan about ever having to leave or do anything. I just do it because I love it. We'll be right back.
Yeah.
I'll take
every day, and then I was given a board by one of his best mates. You're at home for more than 2 weeks or something, and sort of start getting itchy feet again and want to go somewhere else. But it's always exciting traveling somewhere you haven't been. I get bored of traveling around, I mean, going from airport to airport, but once I'm at a destination, that's fine. Well, when I come home, it's pretty much my holiday because I'm away so much. Normally just kick back with friends and it depends on the time of year as well. If it's summertime, we go day trips to places like to that water slide. Yeah, I like going to cities for small periods of time, you know. They get exciting as well, and, you know, we come from a small town to go to a big city, you know. It's all massive, big building, and I like it for 2 or 3 days, and then I've got to get out of there pretty much.
Eric Warner shows up at my house. And I had this old classical guitar that I got for, I don't know, my birthday or something when I was like 12. And I wake up one morning, he's just strumming away, just crazy sounds. I was just like, wait, you gotta teach me something, you know? So I was like convinced that I was gonna learn these three chords so that when he came back, I could sit there and strum chords and he could like play solos. So when he came back down, we could actually play it, you know? And he was like totally surprised. You know, we could sit there and strum the chords and like hold down a little rhythm and he would just sit there and just play solos for like probably hours. I mean, we don't even know how long we'd sit there, but it seemed like forever. You know, he was probably just going, I wonder when these guys are gonna stop playing. Because we weren't gonna stop, you know? It was like food, what? Nothing. Nothing was gonna stop us, so. It's just pretty cool how, like, one person can just, like, cross paths with you at some stage in your life and just have such an influence on you. I don't know, man. I think you do things out of, like, passion, love. And that's basically why I do everything, I think. No, that's like gut-wrenching, man, when you hear that. It's like, wait, somebody goes, oh, dude, I surfed wherever it is, you know? I surfed Seaside yesterday. It was the best I've ever seen it. It was as good as it gets, dude. You missed it. Great. No, it's not so much like that for me in California. Because I think I've surfed those waves as good as I get. It's a crazy thing. It's such a weird sport. You know, it's got like this, it's like you're in love with it.
Residing this village since 1929, and or 20 or 1930, I think. I started fishing when I was 7 years old. busted out all these ones that was around and had someone to say the pulley, the prayer. Thank the Lord for this school of fish out there, you know, and see that if we could catch. And it was quite a group right down at the ramp. I never see that much people out just the past I never heard of. Well, we came up on a winning side of catching. Myself, I had a cooler fish and I shared with three Ohana up on the hillside. Right. You know, your Ohana don't know whether you caught any fish or not, but you know, all of them 2 days surprised, see this monster and a coolie, just like 1 pound size, you know.
Yes.
And they go, wow, you know, and wow, big. So everybody's excited about them. The catch we caught that day. And talk about surfing, we never had boards over here, you know, to surf. But we use logs or whatever flat piece we find.
In CJ's case, he has picked up the surfboard and wanted to become and will become what he wants to become. But it's his choice of. I only can lead the trail, but for him to take it, he has to do it.
Yeah, I was born in the city, mama, but Lord, I played them country blues. Yeah, I was born in the city, mama, but Lord, I played them country blues.
That is time. Well, I had two little girls. I'm so busy. Ooh, city boy living in a country town. Ooh, city boy living in a country town. Well, I had two little girls. daddy's eyes. Come over here, sweet woman, can't you tell your daddy's time?
This is what I dreamt of, what I've been doing for like 12, 15 years. You know, when I was a kid, I wanted to be a pro surfer. I wanted to just travel around and see different places. And my dream was to have surfing kind of provide that. So where I can go and surf and meet different people and eat different foods and see different cultures. And that's kind of enough for me, really. I mean, for me, it's still interesting to travel all the time and be around in different places with my friends. I just can't believe that surfing is there. And I don't really have any huge aspirations that go farther than that. I'm not motivated to try and get to some other level of success. I'm fine right where I am. Totally fine.
Dirty fingers, queenly mother's house. Come step outside, feeling full moon high. See what we can live without. An eye to the dime store villain, waiting for the wine to pour. Come strong and thin, and it tastes like sin. The love we've all been in before. A million ways to burn. I'm just looking out of the soul. Broke window, she's taking a turn. I'm looking out of the soul. Broke window, she's taking a turn.
I try not to talk too much, just because whenever I get in a social mode, it, you know, kind of takes me off my, you know, when you surf pipe, you gotta be on your game. You gotta have a full on, okay, I'm going out there and catch waves. Get psyched, and you know, you kind of have to be more aggressive. It's like competition to try and actually catch a wave of pipe. So you know, when I go out there, I try not to be too like, hey, how you doing? You know, just hanging out. Try and be a little bit more aggressive, you know. So don't really talk story too much. I mean, of course you do. That's kind of part of surfing. But out of pipe, it's more you're just kind of psyched to get the next wave.
Body lies like a landscape before you. Selling your soul by the pound. Got snake oil and spades for the wolf to get straight. You look but don't see me around. A million ways to burn. I'm just standing here on the stone street corner and she's taking a turn. I'm standing here on the salt street corner, she's taking a turn.
Thank you.
noticed that one wave I took off and it was kind of, it looked like it was gonna be good, but it ended up just closing out and I got smashed on the reef and just, you know, the wave like drags you across the bottom, like slams you as far as it can down and then it pulls you across the bottom. Kind of, I was like getting drugged with my hands like so I wouldn't hit my head, and the reef just ripped my ring right off, my wedding ring. So I had to get another one. My wife wasn't happy.
My goal for life is, I guess, to make a difference in this world. You know, I think everyone with all the war and everything going on at the moment, I think everyone's realizing that it's not the answer to a peaceful world. And I think no matter how evil people are in this world, we need to make a difference another way and find another way to make things work.
But they were weeping to find the world at their front door pleading, and the birds of prey are on the wing as the bloodstained doves refuse to sing, while the arrow maker's coffer grows and the monk sweeps up the chapel floors. What goes around comes around. What goes up must come down. The good you do, it follows you. And the ones you hurt remember you. Yes, they do. One world, one world, one world. One world, one world, one world. Just one world, one world, one world. One world, one world. The blind now seeing, for fear refused to speak, and the flock that trusted shepherds to the wolves they now beseech. The sky dims as the storm clouds grow when the riders take to mount, from the desert to the mountaintops, valley to the sea. Widows, orphans in the street do cry, from the chapel door the parson peeps. What goes around comes around. What goes up must come down. The good you do, it follows you, and the ones you hurt remember you. One world, one world, one world. Just one world, one world, one world. One world, one world, one world. Just one world, one world, one world. And the raven's wings did flutter as a million sabers rattled one by one, with tattered banners hoisted high, the students ask the teachers why. As the funeral passes in the streets,
and the teachers start to lie. Over mountains silent vigils kept, the valleys deep below. They search for sanctuary in the wilderness of dreams. Though bloodstained and road weary, the doves begin to sing. What goes around comes around. What goes up must come down. And the good you do, it follows you. And the ones you hurt remember you. One world, one world, one world. One world, one world, one world. One world, one world, one world. Just one world, one world, one world. While satellite orbits ball of confusion, the computer fails to find solutions. The twofold gains in technology was tenfold lost in humanity. Lord, grant me accept what I cannot change, and the courage to change the things I can. I pray for the wisdom to discern between the will that I might sing. What goes around comes around. What goes up must come down. The good you do, it follows you. And the ones you hurt remember you. Yes, they do. One world, one world, one world. Just one world, one world, one world. One world, one world, one world. It's just one world, one world, one world. One world, one world, one world. It's just one world, one world, one world. Aye, rayo!
Did you get it?
Yeah.